things might have been different in the USA
if some of these things had happened.
When Christopher Columbus sailed across the ocean blue, he made his famous voyage with a Spanish-speaking crew. The shores of Puerto Rico were all that Chris could reach. But if his crew was Jewish, he'd have reached Miami Beach.
Things might have been different. Things might have been different.
Pilgrims came to Plymouth Rock, and when their crops decreased, a friendly band of Indians took the pilgrims to a feast. If those were Jewish Indians, Thanksgiving we would eat potato latkes, matzo balls, and strictly kosher meat.
We all remember still. He bought Manhattan Island for a $20 bill. If Peter had been Jewish for not one extra sou, he would have got Manhattan and the Bronx and Brooklyn too.
Things might have been different. Things might have been different.
At Valley Forge, the Continental Army nearly froze. They spent that awful winter with no food and frozen toes. If Washington was Jewish instead of Valley Forge, the army would have checked in up at Grossinger's with George.
Well, things might have been different. Things might have been different.
I wonder if the tale of Ponce de Leon is the truth. They say that he was searching for a fountain full of youth. If Leon had been Jewish, an ancestor of mine, he would have found a fountain full of Manischewitz wine.
When you're in love,
the whole will turn to mink. You seem to fly, you wink and feel so chipper. The moon is a yarmulke high in the sky, and each day is Yom Kippur.
When you're in love,
each deal is a big deal. Never again will man call you a schlemiel. Yes, when you start to fall, the world is your own matzo ball. And everything's borrowed and blue, old and newish. Sort of glass of tea for two-ish. Cause the whole world is Jewish when you're in love. You just take your picture. Mama won't mind to find you brought home a Schickser. You're on the loop, Niagara will spill chicken soup.
Everything's borrowed and blue, old and new.
Lovely, lovely.
Sort of glass of tea for two.
It's a machaya. Cause the whole world is Jewish when you're in love.
Yeah. He was short and fat and rode out of the west with a Mogan David on his silver vest. He was mean and nasty right clear through, which was kind of weird because he was yellow too. They called him Irving. Big Irving. Big short Irving. Big short fat Irving. The 142nd fastest gun in the West. He came from the old bar mitzvah spread with a 10-gallon yarmulke on his head. He always followed his mother's wishes. Even on the range, he used two sets of dishes. Irving. Big fat Irving. Big sissy Irving. The 142nd fastest gun in the West.
Irving.
141 could draw faster than he, but Irving was looking for 143. Walked in the Sol Saloon like a man insane and ordered three fingers of 2 cents plain. Irving. Big fat Irving. Big sport Irving. The 142nd fastest gun in the West.
Irving.
The James Boys was coming on a train at first sun, and the town said, Irving, we need your gun. Well, that train pulled in at the break of dawn. Irving's gun was there, but Irving was gone. Irving. Big fat Irving. Big help Irving. The 142nd fastest gun in the West. Finally, Irving got 3 slugs in the belly. It was right outside the Frontier Deli. He was sitting there twirling his gun around, and Butterfingers Irving gunned himself down. Irving. Big fat Irving. Big dum-dum Irving. Big dum-dum dead Irving. The 142nd fastest gun in the West.
Really?
Pues vamos a beber un cafecito
y comemos un pedazo de pastel.
¡Qué rico!
Vamos de paseo cuando venga Don Miguel. Pues vamos a beber un cafecito. Oh, let's have another piece of pie.
Hip, hip, hooray, hooray, hooray. Hip, hip, hooray, hooray, hooray.
Let's have another cup of coffee.
And let's have another piece of pie.
When you're in love, the whole world is Jewish.
I've had a lot of thrills in my life. Three kids, a gorgeous wife, such looks. I'm thrilled about my car, a Riviera, my sister Sarah, and John O'Hara's books. But the thrill of thrills that gave my heart a clout was the thrilling night when I thrillingly found out. Steve McQueen is Jewish, would you believe it? He's just like you and I, couldn't you almost die? And Cary Grant is Jewish, could you conceive it? Such a living doll in a prayer shawl. Marlon Brando's Jewish, Pat O'Brien and Richard Conte. Not to mention that lovely couple, Harry and Belafonte. Frank Sinatra's Jewish, would you believe it? Sean Connery and Lyndon Johnson too. As a matter of fact, the whole world is Jewish since I fell in love with you, Rosie McGonagall. Since I fell in love.